Dear students, now we are going to talk about scientific principles of sports training. In last class, we have seen about the brief of principles of sports training. Now we are going to see elaborately. So principles of sports training, we are dividing into two categories. One is basic principles, another one is general principles. Under the basic principles, three concepts are there. Then general principles, some other concepts are there. If you understand the concepts of principles of sports training, you can easily apply wherever you go. For example, if you are going to give a training for a beginner, you can apply these principles. In same way, if you are going to give a training for elite players, the same principles you can apply. So as a physical education teacher, as a physical education professional, you must understand about the principles of sports training. So now we will start with the principles of sports training with the basic. Now we are going to talk about basic principles of sports training. So basic principles, we are dividing into three titles. One is specificity, second one is overload, and third one is reversibility. This is basic principles in sports training. We should understand the three concepts so easily we can apply whatever we want, whatever training we want to give, and whatever training athletes we are going to handle, it is very easy to give the sports training. So what is the meaning of specificity? What is the meaning of overload? What is the meaning of reversibility? We are going to see one by one. So what is the meaning of specificity? It means specific adaptation to the stressor. Here, who is the stressor? The stressor means the athlete who is going to get the sports training. He is the stressor. And the effect of stressor to an individual athlete. So a specific adaptation, this is the very, very important specific adaptation. For example, an endurance athlete should have enough amount of endurance quality. In same way, a sprinter should have a sprinting quality. A jumper should have a good explosive quality. So each and every athlete have their own adaptation, their specific adaptation. Here specificity, what it emphasizes, that if you are going to give a sports training, if you are going to give a training, the training should be in specific, not general. But if you are going to develop a beginner, if you are going to select the player from the beginning, so you should concentrate on the general physical fitness. But if you are going to give a training for any athlete who related to some sports activity, some specific sports, so you should give her some specific training. He should get the specific adaptation. The second point is nature of training load. The nature of training load means if you are going to give a training for a football player, you should start with basic training load. For example, you can start with 40% of training load. So automatically the training load should be increased up to their maximum. So you don't start with the 60%, 70%, 80%. So nature of training load should be in progressive one, should be in scientific way. And then specific demands. The specificity should be in specific demands. For example, a 8th standard athlete is going to participate in the long jump event. So you should give a specific training for his performance. You don't concentrate according to the international level athletes. Because he is 8th standard student, you should measure his performance accordingly. You should increase accordingly. You should give us training. You don't initially you don't concentrate on the international level. So automatically, if you will do that, automatically the injury will come. Automatically he may get the performance in peak, but he cannot maintain. The performance will come down, easily come down. Then third point, the training load becomes specific when it has a proper training regime. and structure of loading. Yes, you should have a proper training program, proper training schedule. If you have a proper training schedule, your training ration will be a good. So easily you can give a load and you can give a recovery, you can give an adaptation gun. If you have a proper training program, training schedule, if you have a structure of loading, automatically the intensity and load will be equal. If you don't have the proper plan, proper training schedule, you cannot follow that. So specificity means you should give a sports training according to the nature of the athlete, according to the nature of the event. How will you give? With the proper training schedule. You should prepare a proper training schedule. With the help of this proper training schedule, you can give a training. So it should be in very specific. That is the first basic principles of sports training. Now we will move to second point, that is called as overload. So what is the meaning of overload? Is it necessary? Yes. If it is necessary to provide progressive heightening of the stressor to build with the body to seek a higher state of adaptation. The overload is very, 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 very important, because if you give a overload, then athlete can overcome the his old performance, his previous performance. For example, if your athlete 100 meter sprinter, his performance is 12 seconds in 100 meter. If you want to reduce his timing, if you want to increase his performance, you should give more training. You should increase the training protocol also. Otherwise, he will be in the 12 seconds. If you want to reduce his timing, if you want to increase the performance, so a training protocol also should increase. That is called as overload. How will you increase? So automatically the load, the training load will increase, the intensity will increase. So everything should be in progressively should go high. Then only he can increase the performance. Any improvement in fitness performance requires an increased training load. Yes, if you want to increase the fitness, for example, you have a good flexibility. If you want to increase your flexibility, you should go higher flexibility training. Then only you can increase your flexibility. Whatever you are doing, you don't follow it regularly, otherwise you cannot improve. So the training load, the overload principle is very, very important to increase the performance. Then that load is a stimulus to which the athlete's body reacts. The load should be stimulated. The load stimulate the athlete's body reacts. So the what it will do? Normally we are doing one type of activity. Through overload, we are increasing the fitness and the training methods. So automatically our body will react. Our body will get tired. So definitely the body will get tired and fatigue. But after some days, definitely the performance will increase. Our fitness will increase. If the load is greater than the normal, the body becomes fatigued. So already I have told. So if you give a overload, definitely the fatigue will come. The fitness level will fall down. But after some days, after recovery, after cross the overload, the performance will increase. The fatigue will come down. If optional, the athlete will be more fit after recovery. That is the point. After recovery, so you are giving overload training, then that time he will be in very tired, fatigue, fitness level come down. But after recovery, here the particular athlete performance will increase. His fitness will be increased. So first basic principle, then second principle we are seeing the overload. First we have seen about the specificity, then overload. Then third point, under this overload, we should understand the three concepts. One is intensity, another one is density, and third point is extent. So what is the meaning of intensity? Intensity means rate of doing work. How you are doing the work, how you are doing the fitness work, whether you are doing fast, whether you are doing very slow or normal or moderate, that is the rate of doing work. So how will you measure the rate of doing work? For example, if you want to measure the speed, meters per second, 100 meters, sprint, how many times he is going, what is his seconds. 10th training, kg, how much kg is he using, and jumps, what is the height, what is the distance, number of efforts. This is the intensity. For example, if you are going to give a jump practice for jump training for long jumpers, so you are giving 5 times you should for stride, 5 times for takeoff, 5 times for fly, 5 times for landing. Likewise, you are giving some number of times, that is the number of efforts. So you are giving a plyometric training, what is the height of plyometric box, what is the distance of the jump distance, and how much kg he is going to use for strength training. If you are taking your athlete to the fitness center, gym, so what is his kg, what, how much percentage he is going to do, how much repetition he is going to do, how much set he is going to do, that is comes under strength. And for sprint event, you are going to give a stride, so how much distance, 10 meter stride or 20 meter stride, what is his second, how within how much seconds he has to finish, everything you are going to fix, that is called as intensity. Intensity means that is called as temporal relationship between the load and recovery. So giving some time training, for example, for you are going to give a stride sprint training, so after completing your first repetition of stride, he has to walk or he has to run or he has to jog to reach the starting position. So definitely you can give sometimes for walking, sometimes you can give for jogging. That is called as density. Within the load, you are giving some gap for density, some gap for relaxation. That is called as density. Temporal relationship between the load and recovery. That is called as density. Training session is called as density. So that recovery phase in the training session is called as recovery. Temporal relationship between the load and recovery phase in the training session is called as density. So temporary recovery is called as density. The distance, the timing between your training protocol and finishing it with and second repetition, within that we are giving some relaxation, that is called as density. Sometimes what we will do with the between two sets, we will give some rest, some temporary rest, that is called as density. Then third point is extend. It is the sum of training in terms of time, distance, weight, etc. That is called as extend. Extend means that sum of training, how will you sum, how will you calculate, how will you total the training through timing or distance or weight, whatever may be. So sum, the total sum of training is called as extend. If you understand the three concept, you can give a training, you can fix the intensity, you can fix a density, you can fix a load. Otherwise, we cannot fix the load. So third basic principles of sports training is reversibility. The adaptation brought about the training load. How we are adapting through the training load will gradually weaken when intensity. For example, we are doing same intensity for 1 year. So automatically that intensity will come down. Automatic training load will be equal, very normal, very monotonous. So what you will do? So you should increase the performance so you can concentrate on the overload. And the extent is reduced or density is reduced, the training effect can reverse itself. If the training does not become more challenging, the fitness level plateau stage. This is very, very important. If you follow the same training schedule in long process in months together, definitely there is no overload principles, there is no higher version of your training methods, automatically your fitness level will come down. If the training ends, the fitness level gradually falls, definitely your fitness level come down. That's why we have to follow proper training program, proper progression of load. In fact, the training load must continue. So for example, this week I am going for 45% of load, so I can go for 50% of load for next month. So every month we have to increase or gradually we should increase our training load. Without increasing our training load, and definitely your performance will not increase. You can maintain your performance, so there is no possibility to increase your performance. So if the training load remains at the same level, the fitness rises for a time, then begins to fall. Yes, if this week you are giving good training, so after recovery your performance may come up, your fitness level may be in very high, but after some time definitely your fitness level come down, because you did not give more importance to your training load. You have stopped your training load, automatically your performance will come down. The training load must be increased regularly. This is a very, very important point. Through the load may rise and fall. So you can increase your regular training load. Definitely your performance will be equal. Then across a given period of time. So full period of time, definitely you can increase, you can adjust, you can progress your training load. So the reversibility means, whatever you have done, that you should reverse it. You don't follow it continuously. This month you are giving one type of training, so you don't follow up to 12 months same thing. You should reverse it. You can increase your overload. You can increase your practice method. So definitely it will increase your performance. Otherwise your training will be in the, your performance will be in the plateau stage. So these are all the three basic principles of sports training. First one is principles of specificity, principles of overload, and third point we are seeing that is called as principles of reversibility. These three important principles you should understand and you should apply. Otherwise we cannot get the performance, we cannot increase the performance. This is the basic principles. Whatever training protocol you are going to follow, whatever athlete you are going to select, these are all the basic principles in sports training. Thank you very much. We will meet in next class. Thank you.